Hey guys, Mike here, and in this video we're comparing two good 7-inch tablets that sell for less than 200 bucks, the Asus MeMO Pad HD7 and the Samsung Galaxy Tab 3 7.0. In fact, the MeMO Pad is at least $50 cheaper than its rival, so is the Samsung slate able to justify the higher price? Tag along and you'll find out. It's obvious from the moment you first get your hands on these two devices that the Galaxy Tab 3 7.0 is the better polished slate here. Plastic is used for the entire case, just like on the Asus tablet. But the joints, sides and details are overall more carefully put together on it. Besides that, the Tab 3 is more compact than the MeMO Pad, thus easier to grab and use, but the two are pretty much the same in terms of weight. And like I mentioned before, plastic is used on both of them, glossy and prone to scratches and smudges. So you should get protection cover for either of these if you plan to keep them in good shape. Overall, the Galaxy is the more beautiful device in this head-to-head, at least in my opinion. However, it only comes in white or grey, while the MeMO Pad is also available in some lively colors like yellow or pink. That aside, both tablets offer pretty much the same buttons and connectors, including microSD card readers and microUSB ports. It's worth noting that the card reader is covered by a small plastic cap on the Galaxy, and the USB port is placed on the bottom, while on the MeMO Pad the USB connector is awkwardly positioned on the top. There's also a secondary noise-canceling microphone on the tab, as the cellular version supports voice services. Okay, let's turn our attention on the screens. Both tablets offer fairly good 7-inch displays. However, there's only a 1024x600 pixel TFT panel on the Samsung, as opposed to a 1280x800 pixel IPS one on the Asus. And while I can't say that one clearly offers better colors, contrast or viewing angles than the other, the higher density screen on the MeMO Pad makes it the obvious choice here, as everything is going to look sharper and smoother on it. The Asus slate, on the other hand, lacks an ambient light sensor, so you'll always have to adjust the brightness manually, but that's something you can live with. And then there's the hardware. On paper, there's a faster hardware platform on the MeMO Pad, and that's proven by most benchmark results as well. However, when it comes to everyday use performances, the two are neck and neck. In fact, once you tweak the TouchWiz UI accordingly, the Galaxy gets a bit faster than its competitor. Have a look. All in all, you can use these two for browsing, multimedia activities and games. Speaking about those, the two tabs can easily handle casual titles, but when it comes to something more complex like GTA Vice City, the MeMO Pad tends to choke, while the Galaxy Tab can run it fairly well, with only occasional stuttering. And that once again proves that we should never judge a tablet based on specs and benchmark results. Anyway, we should talk about software for a little bit. Both devices are running Android, but there's a newer version on the Asus slate with a few extra options. Samsung skinned their tab with TouchWiz UI and all the tweaks bundled with it. Some that I for one enjoy, like the notification panel, app drawer or multitasking screen, and some that you might find annoying, like the transitions effects and overly colorful themes. Asus skins their MeMO Pad as well, with their WaveShare UI, but this is closer to what you're getting with stock Android. Even so, it bundles a redesigned notification panel, some extra widgets, a multifunctional home button and some small apps that run on top of your standard Windows. Speaking of that, you might have noticed that the navigation menu is part of the screen on the MeMO Pad and it rotates with the interface and integrates with various apps. On the Galaxy Tab, you're getting the physical home button and dedicated capacitive controls we've seen on all Galaxy smartphones in the past. And to be frank, I quite enjoy this approach on a 7-inch tablet. Anyway, there are a bunch of extra details we should mention when comparing these two. For instance, both feature a set of cameras, but the 5-megapixel main shooter on the MeMO Pad delivers better pics and videos than the 3-megapixel one on the Galaxy Tab. And there's a more capable and friendlier interface bundle on the Asus slate as well. Besides that, both offer stereo speakers. On the Asus, you can customize the output to some extent via the included Audio Wizard app. On the Samsung, the speakers are fairly good, but they are inconveniently placed on the lower lip, so can be easily covered with your palm when using the tablet in landscape mode. Besides that, we should mention that the two offer a bunch of connectivity options with wireless, Bluetooth, GPS and USB on the go. Some versions of the Tab will also offer cellular modems and voice services support, something you're not getting on the MeMO Pad. Last but not least, there's the battery life, where the two are once again neck in neck, capable of offering between 5 and 8 hours of use on a charge based on what you're running on them. If you plan on squeezing the most out of the batteries, both offer some power saving apps, but the one on the MeMO Pad is more customizable. All this being said though, it's tough for me to choose between these two devices. Each has its own pros and its shortcomings as well. The Samsung Galaxy Tab 3 7.0 is very sleek, feels great in hand and offers a good everyday experience. The MeMO Pad has the higher resolution screen on its side. And one more important aspect, the price. For only $149 you can get the 16GB version of the MeMO Pad HD 7, while the cheapest Galaxy Tab, the 8GB model, sells for $199. So unless you really care a lot about design and aesthetics, I consider the MeMO Pad the wiser pick here. That of course if you're on a tight budget and would rather get the best device for as little money as possible. If you however don't care much about money and the poor resolution screen on the Tab, which is in fact its most annoying aspect, I'm pretty sure you're going to be happy with it as well. And with that in mind, it's time to wrap this up. Thank you for watching and please let me know in the comments below which one of these two is in your opinion the better pick, and of course what makes you choose one over the other. I'm looking forward for your replies and I'll catch you later. But we're not ending this review before thanking you for watching it and kindly asking you to share the video and hit the thumbs up button if you enjoyed it. Thanks again and I'll see you in the next clip.